welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Richard Marx. And we are going to react to the song Hazard. Let's get started with our first time single take on this reaction to it.
Yeah. Hazard, I think I heard it. So it may not be my first time.
Okay.
Listen, but let's see. I don't really remember, but it sounds so familiar.
Escape for me.
Wow, this is magical. Richard Marx and his voice and this music, this was phenomenal. And you don't expect it, the way the story is so intense with the music like that. And I'm not sure if everybody would feel it the same, but I felt the music, the way it was constructed, it was two different styles of music that was playing, these instruments, the selections of instruments. First, it sounded more like Peruvian music with their style and their sound, the way it comes. And this one more was like Middle Eastern Arabic sound to this guitar or the instrument that was playing. So it was very distinct they were initially, and then the letter, and then, the keyboards and everything. But this was magical on the ears to listen to, the way he was singing the story and the music, all of them.
This was so deep, so deep. He was cornered, he was caught because of what happened. This girl went missing.
Yeah.
And since he used to hang out with her, he was to blame.
Yeah, people think he did something.
They thought he did something to her. So they all came to arrest him. They were all pointing fingers at him in this old Nebraska town, as he said. And he wants to do the same thing. Maybe he knows what happened to her. Maybe he knows what she did. And he wanted to go down to the river and get out of this place too.
Hmm.
So I feel like he knows what happened to her.
They both wanted to leave. Mentioned. Yeah.
I think she was fed up and she just either ran away or ended things. And he wants to do the same thing. It seems like that way to me. It's so deep. It's so deep. It's so profound. It's musically, it's wow. It's one of the best songs I've heard musically.
Yeah, true.
One of the best songs for sure that I've heard. I do remember it from somewhere, but I don't know where.
A movie or something.
It's been ages, so I don't really recall where I've heard it.
Mm-hmm.
But the way it is constructed, the way it is sung, I think it must have been a huge hit back in the day whenever it came out. So there's no doubt that I may have heard it somewhere or the other. But wow, this listening to the song today, his voice, the music, it's got to be one of the best arrangements of music in music such as this, in this genre. Whether you call it pop, whether you call it rock, this has got to be the best musical arrangements you'll ever hear in songs. And his voice is so heartfelt, it's so genuine.
His voice is great.
He's being cornered, he's being blamed for nothing, and he doesn't know what to do. He's fed up himself of the way things are going. Both of them wanted to get out of that place, but sadly she's gone. Whether she's ended things or she's run out of there safely, we don't know because it's not mentioned. But this is thought-provoking, and this also tells us we need to value our children. We need to value our teenage children, because there's so much happening in the world today. There's so much going through their mind. It's turbulent. It's turbulent times. It's turbulent thoughts. And as parents, as grandparents, as loved ones, elder siblings of theirs maybe, we need to look out. We need to look out for them. We need to make sure that they are guided properly. We need to make sure that nothing like that happens to them. You know, so it's difficult. Things like that can happen to anyone. Anyone's kids, or it could happen to you if you're young. So it's thought provoking. I don't know if it's based on a real story or incident or case. The way it went, it may be based on some real case. In a particular part of Nebraska. So that we don't know about.
I don't know about. Well,
but it sounds very real. Sounds very real. May have been made for a movie. It would have probably fit the whole story of the movie brilliantly, if that is what the movie was about.
You remember that movie, Three Hoardings were there, what was that name?
And actually there's a noun, I'll get to that.
Hmm.
Three hoarding billboards outside Missouri, something Missouri.
Someplace,
Three hoardings, three billboards.
Ebbing Hill.
On outside Ebbing, Missouri or something.
Ebbing Hill or something.
But I think there's a town named Hazard, if I'm not mistaken, in Nebraska.
Okay.
So this is about that town.
It has to be a real story then.
Yeah, it might be real. Might be real. Might be personal also for Richard Marx as an artist, that maybe this happened to him.
Yeah.
And he's sharing what happened.
We, I don't know what is the situation now in the USA, but there was a time and it was massive there. Disappeared people.
Disappearances of young girls
and you know, lesser in percentage young boys. So these disappearances were very common and could be one of those, you know, cases of disappearance where you don't know whether something happened to that person got raped, murdered, kidnapped, what happened, sold to somebody, or, you know, just ran off from home. So you just don't know. The police over there didn't have any results over there.
Missing children, missing youngsters was so common in America that they actually used to print it every single day on milk cartons. At the back of milk cartons, they would print a new picture of someone missing in that location.
Okay.
And it was so common. I remember it's very, very common. Mm-hmm. Was very common. I hope it's not
I hope
so
it's social media and everybody having their smartphones and tracking and everything.
But it's not just America, I to hope be it honest. It's happen. Not only America, it's probably many other countries, including India, where this.
No, when you find the whereabouts of a person, then it is okay. But when you don't know at all what happened. If you're dead, your daddy, people know it, then it is better.
And spare a thought for the parents. You know, parents and friends like him, being a close friend of us. Spare a thought for them, how they must be feeling and what they must be going through. Expecting, this movie showed it brilliantly. Runaway jury. You know, I mean, where you're literally expecting. Not runaway jury, actually. Which movie? You're expecting one day that your kid will return. You know, 8mm, was it 8mm? One day you're expecting,
course,
yeah, 8mm,
yeah,
I think.
Like that,
starring,
yeah,
Nicolas Cage.
Yeah.
We're expecting, the mother's expecting one day the child will come back home, the teenage girl. Yeah. That's it for this one.
This
it's a noisy evening in Mumbai. It's a mega reaction fest, 7 time, and everyone seems to be
lockdown.
In a jubilant time. It's a weekend lockdown in Mumbai, but you would not believe it's a weekend lockdown if you live where we are living. And everyone seems to be out and enjoying themselves.